Chapter 1, Prologue. The tea ceremony makes us understand its Zen essence, already from the name hot water. In the search for absolute minimalism, you get an elaborate ceremony based in the simplicity of action and in the harmony of details. The guest and the host merge, becoming a complex figure in the sanctity of the rite, where everything is cloudy, yet at the same time bright. This leads to a detachment from the object reality of everyday life, which instead becomes the absolute reality of the moment. Introduction. The tea ceremony is one of the most fascinating traditional rituals of Japan. Each act, each movement, is imbued with sanctity, as the strong spiritual aspect brings participants in the ceremony to an inner search for themselves. One of the most notable traditional Zen arts, the Cha no Yu, known in the West as the tea ceremony, is a social and spiritual custom practiced in Japan, sometimes referred to as the road of tea. The shogun Ashikaga Yoshimasa in the 14th century pushed to give the tea ceremony a strong identity and an absolute importance. He in fact constructed the silver pavilion known as the Ginkakuji, which is now the world's oldest tea room. But like most of the Japanese arts, it became codified and systematized at the end of the 16th century by the Zen Buddhist monk Sen no Rikyu, the tea master of Oda Nobunaga, and subsequently of Toyotomi Hideyoshi. The Cha no Yu of Sen no Rikyu resumed the tradition founded by the Zen monks Murato Shuko and Takino Zhu. Everything originates from Sen no Rikyu, according to an old legend from the Chan area that attributes the growth of the tea plant to Bodhidharma, the legendary founder of this Chan school of Buddhism. After having fallen asleep during the zuwakan, a form of meditation, as soon as he woke, he tore off his eyelids to prevent drowsiness again and threw them away. From these, the first tea plants were born. Chapter 2, Sobriety. The ceremony is based on the concept of wabi-cha. It is characterized by the simplicity and the sobriety of the ritual, as well as by its close connection with Buddhist teachings. This ceremony and spiritual practice can be done according to different styles and in different ways. It always uses, in varying quantities, powdered green tea, known as matcha, and thick tea, known as koicha. Hot water is mixed into the powdered matcha with a special bamboo whisk known as a chasen. The resulting drink is therefore not an infusion, rather it is a brew, in that the tea powder is consumed together with the water. For this reason, and for the fact that the matcha is made using the shoots of the plant, the drink has a particularly stimulating effect. In fact, it was and still is used by the Zen monks in order to stay awake during their meditation sessions, known as zazen. After beating the water with a whisk during preparation, the light uchucha tea becomes covered with a thin foam of a color which matches with the colors of the cup. Depending on the season, the location of the boiler, known as the kama, also changes. In autumn and winter, it is placed in a square-shaped hole, known as ro, formed in one of the tatami mats that make up the floor, while in spring and summer, it is in a container, known as furo, resting on top of the tatami. The Four Principles. According to Sen no Rikyu, during the ceremony, four fundamental principles...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.